In the name of the Father and the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Always our pleasure being with you in our lead program. In this episode, we are going to talk about a very critical question. The question is, what are the criteria of successful leaders? What are the criteria of successful leaders? Something bothering a lot of people. Like, really? What's the criteria? What are they? A lot of references and conferences just talking about that. So we are going to make a summary in something that can help you to remember it. In order to answer this question, you have to learn this. 2I, 2S, 1D. 5 criteria. The first I is intelligence. The second I is integrity. The first S is self-confident. The second S is sociability. The D is determination. So, 2I, 2S, 1D. Criteria for successful leaders. Intelligence. Oh, I have to be very intelligent with a very high IQ. No. When they said intelligence, it's called smartness, which is basically use your mind in thinking. Use your mind in thinking, like be logical. So intelligence here means be logical. Evaluate everything and think logically. And then integrity. Do what you say. Do what you say. Be a model. So when you say something, do it. Yeah, but sometimes, you know, I said many things, but I'm like trying to do it. You are on track. Because we are not God. So definitely we will have mistakes. So I want you to teach yourself how to do what you are saying. But always review yourselves to develop yourself in this point. Always try to reach to the maximum integrity as much as you can to do what you are saying. Self-confidence. Be confident in yourself. Why? God created in you a lot of talents and a lot of skills. Yeah, but you know what? I don't know what are my skills. Sit down and review. No way for God to create you without skills. That will never existing. You have a lot of skills, but what's it? You need to know. So please sit and review. What's it? And write it. You will figure out your skills. Once you figure out your skills, use it. You will be having a successful track. And that will bring you the self-confidence. Self-confidence coming from knowing your skills and put it in application to be successful in your life. Sociability. Be social, not to ignore the presence of people around you and just focus on yourself. Oh, that means that people who are like dreamers and always with themselves, they are not be leaders and they will not be leaders? No, no way. When I'm saying sociability, that you have the ability to communicate. To initiate communication or in the communication you can function. But some people, they cannot even communicate and they are trying to avoid people because they are afraid. No. Be sociable. Characteristics of great leaders, one of them is sociability, to socialize with others, to communicate with others. D, determination. Be target-oriented. Determination is to know exactly what's your target and to hit it. Go to your target. Fulfill your target. Many people, they don't know what their target in their life. If you know your target, you will be successful. Successful leaders, they not just knowing their targets, they fulfill it, satisfy it. Dream with your target to fulfill it. Dream well, your dream will come true one day, but you cannot dream without a target. So dream well, so that your dream will come true. This is the criteria which our Lord put it in us to be successful as leaders. So in order to be successful leader, 2I, 2S, 1D. The last step in our episodes as we used to, application. Do we have leaders in the church? or in the Bible, biblical characteristics that have this? Yes. Let's talk about Joseph in the Old Testament. You can pick any leader, but I'm just picking an example. Joseph, intelligent from him, from when he was a kid, logically thinking, always thinking logically, working up his mind. Integrity. He is doing what he is saying. Remember what he did for Potiphar's wife? He is doing what he is saying. He is living by example. Self-confident. He knows his skill concerning the dreams and how to interpret the dreams. And he used it very well, to the extent that the power and the skill which God created in him put him on the top level to be the second man in Egypt after Pharaoh. So, intelligence, integrity, self-confidence, and sociability. Very sociable. In the prison, very sociable with people and can communicate very easily. Can communicate when he was the leader. Even he succeeded to communicate with his brothers after being back, after he was the second man in Egypt. The last thing is determination. D. Very determined, very target-oriented. He knows exactly what he wants, and he did it on the right time, by the right way, with God's support. Application on yourselves. Please, I'm telling you this. Bring a piece of paper. I want you to write these five criteria. I-I-S-S-D. Intelligence, integrity, self-confidence, sociability, and determination. Please write in front of each one. To what extent you are using up your mind, or you are more emotional? And move to the second one, integrity. Are you really doing what you are saying? If not, what's missing? Just write it. Three, go to the point of self-confidence. Do you know exactly your skills? What's them? How do you use them? Number four, sociability. Can you communicate easily with people? If not, what's holding you from the communication? Know exactly. Determination. What's your target for the next step in your life? In service in the church, in your relationship with God, with your family, in the world, in your practical life. What's it? What's your target? Put it and put an action plan to do it. Now, I want you to be careful from something very important. If you are always focusing on yourself and you see that you are using these five criteria, by that way you will be successful, without understanding that God created in you everything, you are on track of arrogancy. Do not be arrogant. In order to humble yourself, you need to understand that the criteria which we are talking about, all of them, God created in you. So please review it with the presence of God, so that God will bless your life and will help you to develop these criteria more. So you will be successful with God's grace, not with your power. Believe me, God created you. That's the first point to be careful of. The second point that I want you to do it, can you determine these five criteria in people around you, in your kids, in your Sunday school students, in your co-workers at work? So now, number one, put this criteria and put yourself so that, read, can you function? What's need development? And then move to the second point. Write the same and put your followers. Which one of your followers have this criteria so you can help them to develop, so that you can develop them as leaders? You cannot develop people around you without developing yourself first. That's why your personal development is before developing others. Develop yourself. This is the invitation of today. Develop yourself by focusing on this criteria on yourself, so that you can develop others around you by helping them to grow as leaders. Serving them. Please serve them. whoever desires to become great among you shall be your servant. Be the one, lead the way. Thank you so much for being with us. Please keep on following us on www.theleadprogram.org. This website is yours. Our pleasure for you to join us in all our lead products, lead program, lead beyond, lead for priests. Thank you so much. Looking forward to seeing you in our next episode.
To lead you must serve, inspired by your example. To teach you must learn, before your visions are reality. Walk what you preach so you can lead the way. To lead you must listen, be open to new ideas, admit your mistakes, to earn the trust of all who follow. Walk what you preach so you can